and welcome to another episode of Homework with Miss Thomas. I am Miss Thomas, and today we will be exploring Lesson 12. The objective is to solve two-step word problems, including applying those strategies that we've been learning in this module. Let's go ahead and jump into it. Use the read, draw, write process that RDW means read, draw, write. Number one, the table shows the number of stickers of various types of Chrissy's new sticker book. Chrissy's six friends each own the same sticker book. How many stickers do Chrissy and her six friends have all together? So we need to figure out how many stickers Chrissy, how many stickers they have all together. So we have Chrissy and we have her six friends. Put that together, it's seven of them, right? Chrissy's one and the six friends is six. Put that together, you have seven. So I'm going to look at this table here to see that they have 32 flower stickers, 21 smiley face stickers, and 39 heart stickers. Let's put together one sticker book. We have three different types of stickers. So I'm gonna do three parts. One part is 32, one part is 21, one part is 39. So these numbers aren't equal. The parts shouldn't be equal, but they are kind of equal looking. So forgive me for that. Now, this is going to be one book. They want us to do seven books. So we're going to do whatever that one book is seven times. Let's figure out what that one book is. 32, 21, and 39. We're putting the stickers all together, right? It said all together. So I'm going to add 2 + 1. Plus 9 is 12. I'm going to write 2 and regroup 1. 3, 2, and 3. 3 and 3 is 6, plus 2 is 8, plus 1 is 9. So one book is 92 stickers. So in order to get 7 books, I would do 92 seven times, or 92 times seven. Let's use standard algorithm. I'm going to start with the ones and do 2 times 1. That is 14. So I wrote a 4, I'm going to regroup 1. Then I'm going to do 9 times 7. That is 63 plus the 1 is 64. So Chrissy and her 6 friends have 644 stickers. Number 2, the small copier made 437 copies each day. The large copier makes 4 times as many copies each day. How many copies does the large copier make each week? So we need to figure out how many copies, copies is the units, the large copier makes each week. All right, they tell us that the small copier makes 437 each day, and the large copier makes four times as much as that each day. Let's do a tape diagram for the large copier. Because that's the one that they're asking us about, right? The large copier. So the large copier makes four times as much as the small copier. So I'm going to do the small copier four times. The small copier is 437. Times 4 will give us that large copier. 437 times 4. Let's do area model. 437 breaks up into 4 hundredths. 3 tens, or 30, and 7 ones. We multiply all of these parts times 4, right? 4 hundredths times 4. Three tens times 4. And 7 ones times 4. All right, 400 times 4 is 1,600, or 1,600. 4 times 30, or 3 tens, is 12 tens, or 120. And then 4 times 7 is 28. Now this tells us how many this copier makes in a day. Right? Let's put them together to see what it makes in a day. We have 8 ones, right? We have 2 tens and another 2 tens to make 4 tens. We have 100 and 600, so that's 700, and just that 1,000. Now, how do we figure out what it makes in a week? Well, I know that there are 7 days in a week. So in order to figure out how many this copier makes in a week, we would have to do it the day amount 7 times. So let's do 1,748 times 7. For the 7 days in a week. All right. 8 times 7 is 56. I'm doing standard algorithm. So I'm gonna write a 6 and regroup 5. 4 times 7 is 28 plus 5 is 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. So I'm gonna write a 3 and regroup 3. 7 times 7 is 49 plus 50, 51, 52. Regroup 5, and then 1 times 7 is 7 plus 5 is 12. So let's type a statement. The large copier makes 12,236 copies each week. Number 3. Jared sold 194 Boy Scout chocolate bars. Matthew sold 3 times as many as Jared. Gary sold 297 fewer than Matthew. How many bars did Gary sell? So, give us a lot of information. They want to know how many bars, that's the units, Gary sells. They tell us exactly what Jared sold. He sold 194. Matthew sold three times as much as Jared. And Gary sold 297 fewer than Matthew. So let's do a tape diagram for Jared, Matthew, and Gary. All right. Jared is 194. We know his exact amount. Matthew is four times that. So I'm going to do 194 four times. Or 194 times four. Gary's is fewer than Matthew. So I'm going to do a tape diagram that is shorter than Matthew. Okay, now this is more symbolic of that 297 less than. So we don't know what Gary's is. We don't know that. But we do know that the whole thing is this 194 times 4. This is the total, right? Part of it is 297. The other part is G. So when we know the whole, we know one part, we don't know the other part, we would subtract from the whole, right? Subtract that part that we do know from the whole. So we have two steps to do here. We first need to multiply 194 times 4. And then whatever this gives us, which will be Matthew's total, right? We're going to take that and subtract 297 from it. All right. Let's do, we haven't done partial products, so let's do that. 4 times 4 is 16. 90 times 4 is 36 tens, or 360. 100 times 4 is 400. Add all those products together, we get 6, 7, and 7. So that is Matthew's. Now we're going to take Matthew's amount and subtract 297 from it. Starting in the ones, I can't do 6 minus 7, so I'm going to take 1. That 7 will become 6, and add 10. The 6 will become 16. 16 minus 7 is 9. 9 minus 6, I can't do that either. So I'm going to take 1 and add 10. 16 minus 9 is 7. And 6 minus 2 is 4. So, Gary sold 479 chocolate bars. All right, for number 4, This time they give us the model, right? The tape diagram is the model. They give us the model. They want us to give them an equation to solve for M. So, as I'm looking at this, I want to think about what I would need to do first in order to solve for M. So, it looks like for M, they want me to add all of this together, right? That's what this bracket here means, add, right? But before I can do that, I have to figure out what this part is. I don't know what this part is. For this part, we are multiplying 723 three times. Once I know what that is, I'm going to add on this other part, right? Which is 973. So in order to solve for M, I'm putting in parentheses what I'm doing first. 723 times 3, and then I'm adding 973. Okay, so that's the equation. This is an equation. An equation is a math statement that has an equal sign. See that? That's how I know it's an equation. I got a variable here. So I'm telling you this unknown number of M is the same as or equal to this expression. Me doing 723 three times and adding on 973. Now, for B, they want us to take that equation that we just created and create a word problem that goes with it and then solve it. Okay, so I'm going to make a story. You don't have to make my story. You can make up your own story as long as you are talking about how you're multiplying 723 three times and then adding on 973. Cinderella ran 973 meters. Miss Thomas ran 723 meters. Donzel ran 3 times as far as Miss Thomas. How many meters did both Cinderella and Donzel run? So if you notice here, I'm telling you Cinderella's amount, that 973. So that first bar is Cinderella's, 973 meters. I'm telling you Miss Thomas's meters, but that's only to show that Donzel has 3 times as much as Miss Thomas. Because in the question, I'm just focusing on Donzel and Cinderella, right? So Miss Thomas has 723, but we aren't calculating that. We're calculating Donzel, who has 3 times as far as Miss Thomas. So that second bar with the D next to it is Donzel's, right? 723, 3 times. How many meters did both Cinderella and Donzel run? First, we're gonna multiply 723 times 3. Let's do distributive property. We're doing 3 times 700 plus 20 plus 3, or 3 times 700 plus 3 times 20 plus 3 times 3. That equals 2100 or 2100 plus 60 plus 9. And that equals 9 ones, 6 tens, 100, 2000. Now we're going to take that and add on Cinderella's, right? 2169 plus 973. Starting in the ones, 9 plus 3 is 12. I'm going to write 2 and regroup 1. 1 plus 6 is 7 plus 7 is 14. I'm going to write 4 and regroup 1. 1, 1, and 9 is 11. I'm going to write 1 and regroup 1. 1 and 2 is 3. Now I'm going to write a statement. Donzel and Cinderella both have 3,142 crayons. All right, that concludes lesson 12, homework. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, keep learning, and I'll see you soon.